hello again and good evening to every one of you watching live here on Beauty and Sound. We are in the fourth night of the Summer 2022 Organ Festival, and we've still got three nights to go after this one. You're in for a real treat this evening. So those of you who were watching last night would have seen five of tonight's organists performing in the Organ Masterclass with Colin Walsh, and what a treat that was. I'm very grateful that all of those organists have returned. They haven't run off. They are here in the room with me now. The good news is that we're actually going to have a little bit of variation from last night. So some of the music that you heard last night will be repeated, so you'll be able to think back to what Colin was suggesting and to see whether those ideas have been filtered through into tonight's performances. And some of the organists tonight are actually playing different repertoire from last night. So thank you all for coming, and I really hope you enjoy the experience. We're going to start this evening with Luke Mitchell, who will make his way to the organ bench now. Luke is 20 and is a first year organist and student at Queen's College, Oxford. He is an established continuo player already and has played with such groups as the Academy of Ancient Music, Instruments of Time and Truth, and the Oxford Philharmonic. Before Oxford, Luke spent a year as the organ scholar at Worcester Cathedral, becoming a prize-winning ARCO, Associate of the Royal College of Organists. In September, he takes up the conducting scholarship with the University Schola Cantorum, as well as being organist of St. Michael's Northgate. Luke is going to open tonight's recital with a really popular and one of my favourite pieces by Bach. It's the epic and monumental Prelude and Fugue in E minor by J.S. Bach, BWV 548, sometimes known as the Wedge. So will you please welcome Luke Mitchell.
Thank you.
Wow, well done. That really was well done. Thank you very much. That was terrific. Very, very musical indeed. I think Colin would be proud of that. I think he's watching tonight. So excellent. Really, what a start. We're going to stick with Bach actually for just a few more pieces. I'm going to introduce now an organist who actually is making his debut appearance here on BIS. So Jake is coming in cold today, having not had yesterday to get used to the experience. So Jake is 22 and started playing the organ at the age of 13. After a long gap in playing and having been to university studying a completely different field. Well, he didn't tell me what that was.
Psychology.
What was that?
Psychology.
Oh, psychology. Jake finally realized, he's actually judging us all right now, isn't he? Yeah. Jake finally realized that music is indeed a passion and decided to study it full time. As a result, as of this September, he's going to the RCM, who is the second person in this room, along with Alexander, who's going to the RCM in September, as well as continuing his position as the organ scholar at St. John's in Notting Hill. In the past year, he's worked for the organ firm Bishop & Sons, and in the future, he'd be very interested in working in the media, working with musicians to share with others the joy of classical music. Well, I'd like to invite Jake up to the organ, bench. So make yourself comfortable, make sure the organ bench is the right height. And Jake is going to play the Komm du nun Jesu Komm Himmel, sorry, I saw that sin. Komm du nun Jesu von Himmel herunter, BWV 650, once again by J.S. Bach. So shall we all please welcome to the organ bench when he's finished raising his bench up. He's quite a tall chap, this this lad. Let's all welcome.
That went down.
Yeah.
That's a good start.
You're obviously not taught how to manage an organ bench in a psychology degree.
No.
Afraid not. So let's all welcome Jake Scicinski.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jake, indeed, for that. It's not one that I play, actually, so well done, well done. Heading up next to the organ bench is Alexander Wilton, who is also heading to the RCM in September. So Alex has been playing the organ since 2014 and subsequently played at numerous churches and festivals in the northwest of England. In September 2019, Alex began his sixth form studies at Cheetham's School of Music in Manchester, where he studied the organ with Christopher Stokes. After leaving Chet's in 2021, he became the organ scholar at Manchester Cathedral. Alexander will commence his studies at the RCM in London in September, along with Jake. And Alex is also very passionate about inspiring the next generation of organists and loves being asked to introduce the instrument to those thinking about taking lessons. So Alexander is now going to play J.S. Bach's Pièce d'orgue, BWV 578. So let's all welcome to the organ bench Alexander Wilton. Thank you. Thank you very much, Alexander. That was lovely. I like the way you end it quietly as well. That's how I end it. I think it works that way, doesn't it? Starts quietly and then ends quietly. Yeah. Fab. Right, up next is Sam Sleath, who is our youngest organist. Sam is 17 and has been studying the organ, playing the organ at least, for 3 years. Initially self-taught, but now having lessons. He is currently studying music and music technology for his A-levels, and in the future hopes to study music further at university. He's currently the organ scholar at Bromley Parish Church, where he also sings in the choir, which is a very useful skill, a very useful experience to do, actually. I do believe all organists should be at least have experience of singing in a choir. Anyone here who hasn't sung in a choir, by the way? They're all not shaking their heads, which is good. So he's, some of you actually may have seen Sam's name in the, those of you who are into Hauptwerk may have seen Sam's name about the scene, because he's actually already sampled some organs. And my chamber organ, which has been all over the country actually, uses Sam's chamber organ sample set, so it's well worth checking out. So please welcome to the organ bench, Sam Sleath, who looks very comfortable. Height okay?
Yeah.
Height's good. Who's going to play the Bélier Toccata in D minor.
Thank you.
Well, I hadn't realized that Sam was actually going to play that from memory. So extra kudos for playing that off score. Well done. I'm going to welcome back to the stage now Jake, who's going to play a movement from the Plymouth Suite by Percy Whitlock, which is called Salix. And I was told only moments before the concert started that Salix actually means the willow tree. Do you know which willow tree specifically it is, Jake? Because I've completely forgotten. I think Luke might know more about this willow tree. Do you want to come and tell people?
My very vague thinking is it could be a sort of Psalm 137 reference.
A reference from Psalm 137. That's very specific.
When they hang their harps upon the willow trees.
When they hang their harps upon the willow trees. So that's what Percy Whitlock may or may not have had in mind. You make up your mind as Jake plays this movement from the Plymouth Suite, Salix. So let's welcome to the stage. Are you going to put it down or up? Or?
I'll be
okay. Yeah, fine.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Jake, for the beautiful Whitlock. I must admit, I don't play any of the Plymouth Suite yet, but I really must learn it. I do play the five pieces and most of the extemporizations. If you do like this video, if you are enjoying it, please do just click the like button. It's entirely free to do that and just requires you to move your mouse just a little bit and press click. It takes about 2 seconds to do. I'd really appreciate it. So we're going to stick in England, compositionally speaking, that is, and we're going to have some Frank Bridge now, played by Alex Hardy. So Alex is a second year student at Trinity Laban in London, and has lessons with Thomas Ullery, and has been playing the organ for 4 years. As well as playing the organ, he's also a choral scholar at the Royal Naval College in London. So as I was saying earlier, I think it's really important that organists get experience of singing. Alex is a very experienced singer. So he also plays the organ regularly at the chapel in Greenwich, where he plays voluntaries and regular pieces of choral music as well, in the absence of the home team. Alex hopes that after university, he will end up doing something with his keyboard or vocal skills. Let's see what that something may be. So let's please welcome to the BIS organ bench, Alex Hardy, who will play the gorgeous, unnamed piece by Frank Bridge, but the tempo marking is Lento, and it's to be found in the publication for Hubert Parry. So Frank Bridge's Lento. Well done, Alex. That's lovely. Sticking in that sound world, we're going to have one of, I think, one of the most beautiful pieces of English organ music, arguably, ever written. That's my opinion, anyway. So, in my opinion, that's a fact. That's not an argument. It is the beautiful folk tune by Whitlock. So it's the second time we're hearing Whitlock tonight, and it comes from the Five Short Pieces. And it's going to be played by Adam Heron, who's 23. So Adam began piano lessons at the age of 8 and became interested in learning the organ shortly afterwards. I think, and started learning at the age of 18, didn't you actually? Started learning the organ at the age of 18. After achieving his grade 8 piano. He's now playing for church services and recitals alongside completing his Master of Engineering course at the University of Sheffield. Adam has now returned to Durham and continues to pursue his interests in music alongside his career in renewable energy. And I like this. This comes from Adam himself. He hopes one day to learn the entire works of J.S. Bach. I think we all want to be able to do that, Adam, but I'm not sure we all can. I'm not sure I could. So you might beat me to it. So Adam's actually going to play two pieces for us. He's going to play the Whitlock, which I mentioned a moment ago, the folk tune. But then he's also going to play, could I say, a world premiere performance. Yes, a world premiere performance of his own Fanfare. So that gives me an opportunity just to very quickly plug the call. Could you pass me that book under my my pristine organ shoes? Thank you very much. Gives me an opportunity to plug this new Call for the Composer's book. A lot of you will have seen it already and you'll be aware of it, but it's available to buy. It contains 25 pieces by composers such as Adam. Adam actually has 4 pieces in there. He's a very fine composer indeed. So without further ado, it looks like he's now ready and raring to go. Let's all welcome to the BIS organ bench, Adam Heron.
Thank you.
Thank you, Adam. Thank you very much for bringing your fanfare and the Whitlock, and look forward to maybe you submitting that for a future call for composers. Right, so where's Sam? There you are. Sam, you're going to play the William Harris Prelude in G, is that right?
Yeah.
So we've had a few pieces by J.S. Bach, and of course we've had a few English pieces on this wonderful organ, which you, if you haven't already guessed or worked it out, we are in virtual St. Lawrence Kirk in Rotterdam, which is in the Netherlands. A really fine organ, chosen because I really wanted to have that clarity, particularly last night for the masterclass. It's really important when doing a workshop like that to have a really clear organ. And of course, it's very broad in its ability to play all sorts of repertoire, particularly Bach. And I do believe this organ does English music very well as well. So, Sam, are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's hear the Prelude in G by William Harris, played for us tonight by 17-year-old Sam Sleath. Thank you, Sam. Alex Hardy, can I invite you back up? Would that be okay? Now we're going to have our final two pieces this evening, and we're going to head into France for two pieces by Louis Vierne. Two very contrasting pieces, actually. The first is the Berceuse, which comes from the 24 pieces in freestyle. And then the second piece will be a rather different style indeed. It's more like a toccata, but we'll get to that in a moment. So, Alex, how's the organ bench?
Yeah,
it's fine. Good. Well, let's welcome back Alex Hardy. Thank you very much, Alex. It's worth pointing out that Alex is actually our second youngest here today at 19. Someone else who is 19 is also called Alex, although I think he prefers to be called Alexander, actually. And he's going to end tonight's programme with a bit of a bang, hopefully not literally. He's going to play the finale from the first organ symphony by Louis Vierne. This piece essentially needs no introduction at all. You'll all know this. It's very well known. In fact, the whole symphony is rather extraordinary, and it's a bit of a shame that this movement, in some ways, overshadows the symphony, because it's the first two movements, the Prelude and the Fugue, are particularly moving, I think. Anyway, I think we should get on to Vienne another time in more detail. For now, well, let's listen to the one of the few pieces, actually, in a major key by Louis Vierne. His symphonies actually get a bit darker. There are six of them, and they get more and more somber and serious. This movement is in D major, very much in D major. It's terrific fun, and I think you'll really enjoy it. So Alex is ready. He's got the page open. He's going to press the button any moment. You'll hear a big clump. Let's listen to it. There it is. That's a very satisfying sound. So, Alex, are you ready?
Yes.
Yes, let's take it away. So please welcome to the BIS Organ Bench, Alexander Wilton.
Thank you. Wow, well done. I think that was a really good ending, isn't it? Well done, Alexander. Terrific. How do you feel?
Oh, great. I'm tired after that now, but
he feels tired, but he feels great. It is. It's very satisfying, isn't it, to do that sort of thing?
Yeah,
so well done. Well done, Alex, Jake, Sam, Alex, Luke through there, and Adam through there as well. Thank you all so much for participating in tonight's JJOR. This is actually the third Joint Junior Organ Recital that I've put together. But of course, it's the first time that we've done it live. I think from now on, it will have to be live because it's just, it's so exciting. There's something really energetic about being in the room so close and seeing everyone do it. So thank you for being my guinea pigs. I've really enjoyed it and it's been really, really thrilling. I hope you've enjoyed it as well. I'm really sure that you have. If you have, you can just do some very simple things. You can click the like button. You can tell people about the video. They might enjoy it as well. You never know. There's no reason for them not to like it. And of course, you can subscribe to the channel. I'm sure you already have. Tomorrow night, we are still in full swing here in the 2022 Summer Organ Festival. Tomorrow night, we have a rather special organ recital for you. Another organ recital. Who says you can have too much organ? So Marco Sever is coming, or should I say already has been, to record his recital for tomorrow. I've seen it, and I can tell you, hand on heart, that every one of you will find it absolutely astonishing. He plays, I think, put it this way, you know the standard of organists we've had here on BIS. Marco is certainly up there as one of the best. The final piece by Gue, which I didn't know at all, really, literally takes your breath away. So if you miss that, I promise you, you are missing out and it's your loss. You've got to tune in. 8 o'clock, that's UK time. I don't know what time that is for you in America or Australia or wherever you are. You've got to do the translation yourself. It's not too hard to work it out. But it's 8 o'clock UK time. So thank you all once again. Can you all tell you what? Just all come and stand around here. Let's all get on the screen and we can all sort of wave. Well, we can all squeeze on like we did last night for our picture.
There's some lovely comments in the chat.
All come on, don't be shy. Come on, Adam. There's a space around here, look. Here they all are, look. Here they all are. You can't quite see them all, can you? You can see Sam, but you can see Alex's jacket. Luke, if you lean in, Luke. Go on, Luke, come around here. Come around here, look. There he is, look, there he is. There he is, so we're all in now. So I think we should all say our very, very cheesy BIS cheerio. So good night, everyone. Take care, stay safe. Cheerio.
Cheerio. Cheerio.
How cheesy, I know, but you've got to have a catchphrase, otherwise it doesn't work. See you tomorrow, everyone. Take care.